A warm welcome to our session, Are You Ready? To move from Solution Manager to SAP Cloud ALM. So this session will look at the transition from Solution Manager to Cloud ALM in more detail. Let's look 3 years back. 3 years back when we launched SAP Cloud ALM at ALM Summit 2018 in Heidelberg, we have also clearly said to all ecosystem of ALM that a solution manager customer should not really look at cloud ALM before 2022, as we would need to complete our roadmap for functional maturity to really reach a similar functional maturity level than we have today. 2022 is not far away, and we are now, I think we can now really have a deeper look and compare Solution Manager and Cloud ALM. So first time ever, we really look at the Cloud ALM through the eyes of a Solution Manager customer, and we'll basically compare on a high level the functionalities on both ALM platforms. Keep in mind that Solution Manager is still a strategic ALM platform with mainstream maintenance until end of 2027 and further mainstream and further maintenance options thereafter, right? So basically Solution Manager will be available for many more years to our customers. But if customers are actually moving to the cloud, and if customers would like to have a lower TCO environment to manage their SAP-centric landscape, then SAP Cloud ALM might be a very good fit for them going forward. I will look at the comparison of Solution Manager and Cloud ALM from four angles. From the angle of functionality, that angle will be the majority of the presentation. Before I jump into the functional comparison, I would like to go into three other aspects that are also touched in the keynote of the ALM Summit this year. And this is the supported and recommended landscape. This is an architectural comparison. And then finally, a couple of remarks. How via tools and services the transition to cloud ALM is envisioned to work. From the functional side, the majority of the presentation will really be to go through the 16 functional blocks of Solution Manager and to explain how these use cases have their counterpart in either cloud ALM or a friend of cloud ALM that overall would take over the functional parts of that use cases. So this will be the details of the presentation. And before I jump into the functional overview, I would like to go into the three other parts very quickly. It's a recap of the keynote. So number two is the recommended ALM solution per landscape. So this is basically what ALM solution do we recommend for a given landscape that you have. And here the storyline is, if you have to implement cloud products, then the clear choice should be cloud ALM. Why? Because Solution Manager does not bring content for implementation of those cloud solutions. You would basically start with a naked Solution Manager and you would have to manage the implementation without content support for business processes or task content. And then there are three products out there which are supported by both Cloud ALM and Solution Manager. These are on-prem products and these are ABAP-oriented on-prem products. And that is actually SAP S/4HANA on-premise, SAP Business Suite, and the SAP Business Warehouse. Those products would be managed by both ALM platforms. And then we have the non-HANA and non-ABAP components of on-prem products of SAP that going forward will still only be supported by either Solution Manager or Focus Run, but there are no plans to support those from Cloud ALM. The exception is the Java-oriented sub PO and PI, where we plan to have an integration of PO PI into the integration monitoring. However, we will not compromise on the need, on the agentless setup of Cloud ALM. Yeah. So Cloud ALM, in contrast to Solution Manager, does not need an installation of agents on the on-prem systems. In the cloud, that's anyway not possible for you to do it. And from that perspective, we don't want to compromise that. So we will find a way to integrate POPI in Cloud ALM without a need for agents. Now, talking about architecture and agents, that's a big benefit of Cloud ALM compared to Solution Manager, is basically the lower TCO from two perspectives. First of all that agent installation and handling goes away. You don't need that anymore for the on-prem landscapes of what SAP Cloud ALM supports. And finally, you also have no installation maintenance efforts, no support packages, no patches to update. Actually, SAP takes care about all the maintenance of its cloud solution. Still, we are deploying daily, and we are releasing features every 2 weeks with updates of our documentation. So we are really a true cloud-native application with a very fast speed and release frequency. We are open for own content and extensions. So if partners would like to co-author content for their industry solutions, they are absolutely invited to do so and publish that in the delivery infrastructure on SAP Cloud ALM. Sometimes I get the question, what about the connectivity between Solution Manager and Cloud ALM if I need to run both in parallel? So first of all, in the long run, we believe that customers should only have one ALM solution and not, let's say, an orchestra should not have two orchestrators. However, in the short term and in the middle term, there might be the need of running two ALM solutions in parallel. We don't plan for any federation between Solution Manager and Cloud ALM. However, both products have obviously their APIs, so that on a project base, you can obviously integrate both if you feel that this is a need. The last aspect of the transition to Cloud ALM is actually the support we have for the transition from the tool and service perspective. And the first support we want to provide for the customers is to support the timeline finding for the transition. For that, we will release an SAP Cloud ALM readiness check that will scan the SAP Solution Manager and will inform the customer about, let's say, simplification items, in the words of S/4HANA, that in Cloud ALM will not be available in that form, or it will be just available in another form. And my functional overview, that is the majority of the presentation today, will exactly explain those differences between Solution Manager and Cloud ALM. The roadmap service is also a service that we would like to offer you going forward, to basically provide a service to Solution Manager customers, how they should adopt Cloud ALM. How does the Cloud ALM implementation will really look like? I mean, as a greenfield customer being new in ALM, I mean, it's clear you request your private tenant via this one support launchpad. And from there, you then wait until the provisioning is finalized. This is less than 15 minutes. And then you connect your landscape and configure a little bit the use cases. And then basically you're productive already. So it's a very fast time to market. For a brownfield customer using Solution Manager already, the same procedure applies. So we have no conversion that is planned for the transition from Solution Manager to Cloud ALM, but you basically request a new tenant. And then we will provide a data transfer selectively for those use cases where it really matters. And that are these areas where you invested a lot in master data, yeah? For example, in process content or in test content. Yeah? We believe that for these areas, we need to provide you a data transition from the Solution Manager into Cloud ALM. This is also subject to customer influence. So we have started influencing groups, also in the German user group, where we are about to discuss those topics. You might remember the situation in 7.2, where 2 years before 7.2 was available, we have started actually discussions about how to move solution documentation from 7.1 to 7.2. And when the release and the mass readiness was ready there, then really also all the tooling was available. And we are trying to really strive for the same, for the transition from Solution Manager to Cloud ALM. Already today, we have expert-guided implementations for SAP Cloud ALM and an SAP Cloud ALM launch check that our colleagues from Preferred Success and Enterprise Support are ready to deliver to you as part of your service entitlements. Good. Having that said, I would like now to go to the main part of this presentation, which is actually the first ever comparison between Solution Manager and Cloud ALM from a use case perspective. I explained already several times that we have no aim for feature parity. However, we must make Cloud ALM so attractive that Solution Manager customers are happily moving over, and they don't see just, let's say, TCO improvements, but they see also a better fit of the Cloud ALM solution that they are actually consuming then for the landscape that they are now in, yeah, and will evolve to, which is basically a more cloud-centric or hybrid landscape. So I will show the 16 use cases of Solution Manager, and I will go through the use cases step by step, starting with project management, going down to the guided procedure framework. Yeah, and the presentation is totally aligned, so meaning all the 16 steps of functional overview will always work in the following way. I'm giving you an overview what was the majority or let's say the focus of the Solution Manager use case. What is it what we are going to do on the Cloud ALM side? And if the use case is not fully covered by Cloud ALM, what are the friends of SAP Cloud ALM that going forward will also take over some of the functional aspects of that use case in Solution Manager? Yeah, so that's the format we will be using to introduce you that comparison of use cases between Solution Manager and Cloud ALM. And keep always in mind, it's not a feature comparison, because on the feature level, we are not trying to be complete, but we are trying to really be complete on the use case level and adapt the features really to the new landscape gravity and reality of our customers that definitely is different than 15 years ago when Solution Manager was basically launched. Okay, and let me start with project management as the first use case. In Solution Manager, we have full C project support with financial resourcing and staffing. And we have a cross-project management in Solution Manager. In Cloud ALM, the focus is on tracking the build project progress. So more looking at the progress from the software solution, you might be reminded of actually our focus build solution that also focuses very much on the solutioning progress. What we are not providing in Cloud ALM going forward is financials, resourcing, and staffing, which, by the way, not so much Solution Manager customers were actually using. If that functionality was used, it was rather in a separate system where then the project portfolio management solution would be used. Not so many really used it on the Solution Manager side. Going forward, this will be a capability that sits in S4. You can use for financial and resource planning either EPPM or Cloud for Projects. And these S4HANA capabilities we plan to integrate into Cloud ALM going forward in more detail. Let's move to the second use case, process management. In Solution Manager, our focus of the use case process management was a very solution-driven process management and a focus on solution documentation. There were, again, very few customers, and our also capabilities were not so great for the business-driven process management and to have really a process portal that would really allow all the employees in an enterprise to look at the processes that are relevant for a customer. Actually, that is the big strength of Signavio, and it always was, right? While Signavio always positioned itself for that business-oriented view, we were strong and we are still strong on the solutioning side. And we would like to basically do the team up with Signavio in exactly that way, that going forward, our focus in Cloud ALM will be solution-driven process management with a very simple library and version management that is reducing the, let's say, complexity of our Solution Manager Unified Directory, however, still providing a certain lifecycle functionality in Cloud ALM. And the business-driven process management and the process portal would be taken care of in Signavio, or if you like, also by third-party BPM tools going forward via API integration. We'll also do the integration between Cloud ALM and Signavio. We would like to take it to the next level by reusing the graphical modeling capabilities and the storage for diagrams within Signavio and reuse that going forward in Cloud ALM. Today, we are still based on the Sybase Power Designer graphical controls, and we will replace that over the course of the next 12 months, most probably, towards the Signavio solutioning, so that basically a certain part, or let's say a microservice of Signavio, would be part of Cloud ALM, not the full Signavio solution, obviously, but basically a microservice. And that would be a big benefit to our customers, because customers would then be able to seamlessly integrate between Cloud ALM and Solution Match in both directions. You could start with Solution Match with Cloud ALM and move over seamlessly into Signavio and vice versa, because we are not replicating diagrams anymore. And we are using the same graphical engine so that there are no hiccups in the diagram transfer. On the test management side, the focus in Solution Manager is test planning, manual testing, defects, which is also the goal for Cloud ALM. Defect is still on our roadmap. The other two are already available. In Solution Manager, we have a test automation capability and an integration to test the third-party test automation. The test automation capability is the well-known component-based test automation. And we have an own test data management, and then also coming with focus build, the test system refresh. In Cloud ALM, the test automation strategy that we have is to provide either the test automation capability that comes with the cloud product that we are doing for S/4HANA Public Cloud. S/4HANA Public Cloud provides actually test content as well as a test automation tooling as part of their solution, and that today already fully integrates into Cloud ALM. For all the other cloud products of SAP and third-party products, we have the partnership with Tricentis, and our goal is that during 2022, Tricentis comes up with a cloud-native version of their test management, test automation solution, and we then are ready to integrate Tricentis in Cloud ALM. That would mean that you can, after the provisioning of your private Cloud ALM tenant, you can also have a Tricentis test automation tenant that you can request going forward, and that these two systems would be hooked up with each other, and you would get at least the SAP-oriented test automation for Tricentis as part of your enterprise support Cloud Edition agreement, very similar than our TTA approach that we have today for Solution Manager already. You have basically a free version of TTA included in enterprise support coming with integrated with Solution Manager. So we will match that going forward in 2022. On the change control side, our focus in Solution Manager is requirements. We have a change workflow for urgent standard and so on. We have defect correction. We have rich functionality for release management, retrofit, downgrade protection, and CISOL for multi-track landscapes. And we integrate pretty much all the deployment providers that are playing a role in the SAP context, meaning ABAP TMS, Cloud TMS, CCTS, CTS Plus, and GTMS. In Cloud ALM, we have already today requirements. A lot of the other capabilities, meaning the defect correction and the release support, is actually supposed to come within this year. And we have also decided that going forward in 2022, we want to provide also retrofit and downgrade protection CISOL capabilities in Cloud ALM. Because we believe that the on-prem reality will still be that you still have to manage dual track. It's not a priority for now, for this year. For us, it's still an advanced capability. But in the meanwhile, we have decided that we would also like to provide such a capability. And that is also based on customer feedback that we got from mature Solution Manager customers. From the deployment providers that we will integrate in Cloud ALM, ABAP TMS, this is already integrated today. And then we will also include a Cloud TMS that will come within this year. Cloud EMS brings us the integration into the transport mechanisms for the SAP business technology platform. And within Cloud EMS, we also expect that the cloud products will integrate so that also their cloud deployment providers can integrate into Cloud ALM. What is also on our roadmap is to take the ABAP-based transport for S/4HANA public cloud, which is not ABAP TMS, but a little bit a separate ABAP transport system that also will be integrated in Solution Manager, in SAP Cloud ALM by 2022. What is usually also relevant in the change control part is not just the technical transport layer, but also the process control, including approvals. And what we are doing here is actually that we can connect the artifacts that we have now in change control, which is basically the requirement and the feature. Now you can compare the requirement in Calm a little bit with the request for change, and the feature you can compare a little bit with the change document. Yeah, if I compare it with Charm. But if you would like to have a full workflow, yeah, what you could do basically in a change document based on workflow, on the ABAP workflow of NetWeaver, going forward, you will be able to also have a workflow capability, but you would then link the feature and into such a BTP workflow. And with that, we would also allow a digital signature going forward, because that's a capability that BTP would provide us. We could also allow you that you integrate into third-party workflows. If that is what you want, we will open up the APIs. The next part is the customer IT service management. This is basically a solution measure capability to provide incident, problem, and knowledge management to you. Here I have to say that we are not planning a comparable offering in Cloud ALM. So this is definitely a capability, customer ITSM, which going forward will be available through third parties. You can obviously still use Solution Manager to manage IT service management. That's still possible. But also I see a lot of moves in the ecosystem towards third party solutions. We have decided not to provide an own ITSM solution because of the strong consolidation in the market and very strong products out there, right? So basically that we would like to concentrate just on the stuff that only we can do. And definitely in the customer ITSM, we see that as a commodity in the market, which not necessarily we need to recreate, as there are very good solutions out there. However, something that is very specific to us is the integration of support from our UIs and the integration into our support backbone. In Solution Manager, we had that capability that you can could basically from SubGUI and Fiori launch actually a ticket towards SAP. That capability going forward will be covered by built-in support. Built-in support is already integrated into S/4HANA public cloud, and more cloud products will come throughout the next year. So basically built-in support, our goal is that all the cloud products are actually consuming that. So with that, you would also be able to create a ticket right away from the UI, not going through a portal, but right away from the UI of SAP. Very similar idea than embedded support in the Solution Manager context. With that, we have the big benefit that the complete backpack at the point in time where the support request was launched is attached to the ticket and transferred over to the supporting units. Built-in support going forward also is planned to be integrated into the ITSM of the customer, and then it is already integrated today into the support backbone of SAP. There is another thing we are trying to do in 2022, and this is to allow that built-in support can also be integrated into ITSM systems of customers. So if you have, for example, a ServiceNow solution, we would be able that ServiceNow integrates built-in support next to the ServiceNow portal. And with that, you can also send a ticket directly from the ServiceNow built-in support into the ticketing of SAP. Obviously, for that, you would need the appropriate S user, or going forward, the counterpart that will come It's part of the global identity project of SAP. Talking about analytics, we have obviously in Solution Manager a lot of embedded analytics and cross-use case analytics coming with focused insights. Embedded analytics is also very famous in cloud ALM. We are providing that also. And for the cross-use case analytics and also the cross-product analytics, meaning analytics when you're using different ALM products in parallel, would go for SAP Analytics Cloud. For SAP Analytics Cloud, we are also providing you, first of all, the APIs, but also some templates that my colleague Xavier Duparat will also share with you on the summit. So here we have basically a friend of Cloud ALM that would say it's basically sit in either SAP Analytics Cloud or in a third party that you could also use via the APIs we provide. Business process operations. Let me move to the operations part of SAP Cloud ALM Solution Manager comparison. For business process operation, we have obviously in Solution Manager a capability for process monitoring and process improvement. And process specifically for these two use cases, they have a very broad KPI coverage for S4 and the business suite with over 1,000 KPIs supported. In Cloud ALM, we have decided to only focus on SAP on continuity monitoring, meaning making sure that we are always that we keep the lights on. The more the use case, which is more about improvement, yeah, meaning taking a step back, looking what overall happens in the system, and then improve the process and improve the throughput, is a use case that going forward will not be available in Cloud ALM, but in a friend of Cloud ALM, which is the BPI portfolio, stands for Business Process Improvement. So Signavio and BPI will take over that process improvement capability, and in Solution Manager, our focus will be only on business process continuity. That means that also all the KPIs that we have in Solution Manager that are not really real-time, but those KPIs that are really aiming at improvement, meaning KPIs that have more, a relevancy in terms of weeks or even months, right? We don't plan to integrate that into Cloud ALM. You would see that in BPI. And I think that makes perfect sense also from a customer point of view, because that are really more business-facing things, and they should basically be in the business-oriented portfolio of SAP, which is BPI and Signavio. On the integration and exception monitoring, our focus in Solution Manager is, first of all, on premise products on statistic level. So we are not going really on a single tracking of every message. And we have a connection monitoring for on-prem. In Cloud ALM, we have a very broad coverage of cloud products plus S4HANA and the business suite, but we do it on single message level, meaning we are really tracing each individual execution of a message, while in Solution Manager, we are only having an aggregated view. And it's a big advancement in functionality, because at the end, you would like to see if a single execution fails, you would like to look in the payload of that. We already obviously still integrate very tightly into the managed system so that you also can look at payload of every single message. So that capability, I would say, is not only available in Cloud ALM, but it's even much stronger because it has a broader coverage. It supports all the hybrid world of the customers. And it has this item level visibility. The user and performance monitoring also comes stronger in the Cloud ALM compared to Solman. In Solman, we had only synthetic user monitoring and only for HTTP and only HTTP based. In Cloud ALM, we have already today real user monitoring going really on single item level, meaning we track every single click in an anonymized fashion. And we, going forward, will also provide the synthetic user monitoring that we have today in Solution Manager, will be also available in Cloud ALM going forward. And we plan to do that not only HTTP-based, but also Selenium-based, so that you can also use Selenium as your robot script generator. Application monitoring, this is an artificial term combining data consistency management and job management. In Cloud ALM, our focus will be on job monitoring, meaning we will not provide you those scheduling and job documentation capabilities. It's pure monitoring of jobs. The data consistency management is not yet available, but we are aiming to provide a similar capability for data consistency management for the products, obviously, we support in Cloud ALM, which I laid out to you before, meaning all the S4 versions plus BW and the business suite. Root cause analysis. Here we have very vast features in SOLMAN, end-to-end trace, exception, workload change, configuration, and security analysis. And in Cloud ALM, we will provide similar functions. They will be named differently. They will be you will be able to find them in embedded analytics. A lot of that is pretty much already available in embedded analytics of Cloud ALM today. In the system management area, we absolutely had a very strong focus on solution management. It's actually where Solution Manager grew up and was famous for. We have a very broad scope for system monitoring for on-prem with all the operational system and database support that our on-prem products are supporting. In Cloud ALM, we are really decreasing the scope here because obviously we believe that the system monitoring for a cloud-centric customer would not be the focus of what happens within the customer organization anymore. If you would have still this on-prem loads that you need to run, we would expect that you would run that more in a private cloud where you basically where you ask the service provider either internally in your organization or externally with a service provider, and they would then have focus run to centrally manage these on-premise centric landscapes where you might still have non-HANA databases to support or even Java systems. They are not in focus of Cloud ALM. In Cloud ALM, we have come up lately with a very lightweight system monitoring for ABAP and HANA-based components. We call that actually health monitoring. And with health monitoring, you can actually look at the health of ABAP and HANA-based on-prem systems, but also on the health of cloud services, and you can combine them in one health monitoring. There is a very specific functionality that usually is customers are using heavily in system management, which are the system recommendations, meaning giving you an idea what nodes you should apply, what security nodes you should apply. And that is a very the famous kind of functionality called system recommendations. That is currently transferred over to the maintenance planner. I think that's also where it belongs to, because at the end, this is maintenance planning, what you do there. So this capability will be part of the maintenance planner, which is basically a free service that you can access from support launchpad and then going forward also so SAP for me. Service availability management is another artificial word with which I combine the IT calendar, the SLA management, and the downtime management of Solution Manager. In Solution Manager, our focus was to maintain and report the service quality at a technical level. In Cloud ALM, we are trying to bring that more to business service level. We call that business service management. Here you can consolidate any technical service or the business services with a visualization approach. The business service must not necessarily be connected to the process documentation. Sometimes the operations view on processes are different than the implementation view. We have that as a very prominent discussion in the solution manager space, where we always tended to reuse processes stored in implementation and then reuse it for operations. This didn't work always out, and therefore we decoupled it here in Cloud ALM. A business service is ultimately a tag that you can provide at your own pace, and then you can put the relevant technical and business services behind that, and then call that a business service. By the way, via business service management, you can also integrate our cloud availability center, where basically you see any hiccup or outage information from SAP and see that in context of a business service, so that you don't have to switch between, let's say, Cloud ALM as your central monitoring infrastructure, and that those functionalities in Cloud Availability Center, where you would basically have a view on the health on the operations in our cloud operations. In event and alert management, we can basically declare that we would still have these capabilities, obviously, in Cloud ALM. However, it comes a little bit in a different form. While we had in Solution Manager an integrated event and alert management where this was tightly coupled, in Cloud ALM, we have event processing and alert management decorrelated. That means basically that in our intelligent event processing and alert management, there would be an event fired, and you can then create an alert out of it, but you're not forced to it. Yeah? So a little bit a different approach towards event and alert processing compared to what we have today in Solution Manager and Focused Run. But I mean, at the end, right, you're also getting smarter every day. And these are, let's say, things that we learned over the course of the last years and experience in deploying Solution Manager and Focused Run. And we saw that it's a smart idea. So these are just improvements that we are basically having as part of Cloud ALM from the experience of 15 to 20 years ALM operations. And then my final aspect of comparison on the functional side is the guided procedure framework. In Solution Manager, we have a framework where you can author guided procedures so that basically you can auto-react on any alert and come to the idea of a self-healing system. In Cloud ALM, what we do here is that you can basically link an alert with an automation engine. And that automation engine can either be the SAP Business Technology Platform workflow. It also can be an SAP IRPA, meaning a bot in our intelligent robotics process automation solution. Or it can also be a content, automation content, that comes for BTP with the SAP automation pilot. So these are three sources of automation, and for the SAP BTP and for the SAP RPA, these are very flexible and open authoring environments where you can also author your automations, where partners can also author automation and connect that to an alert in SAP Cloud ALM. Yeah? So also here, right, when I summarize all the 16 use cases, I would say we always have, so to say, an analogon, yeah, because we believe that these 16 use cases are all still relevant, a little bit in a different form, yeah, and with a different gravity when it comes to the interplay between Cloud ALM and its friends. Yeah. But at the end, important is that a solution is available for the customer, and definitely we would have that. One last remark, one aspect that I didn't cover so much is actually the custom code lifecycle management. Our plan, I mean, today already custom code management is actually already available in the OneSupport Launchpad. We have talked to the custom code lifecycle management guys. They believe that they should also move into Cloud ALM and provide, let's say, a capability like custom code lifecycle management in a new updated format also in Cloud ALM. This is a little bit longer roadmap, not sure if it comes in 2022, but we are also working on this aspect of Solution Manager functionality to provide you with an appropriate feature in Cloud ALM. All right. Yeah, with that, I'm concluding my first trial to compare Solution Manager with Cloud ALM from the functional side. Janko and Michael have, let's say, detailed Excels where they can give you even, let's say, this on the feature level. But I think as an introduction, I hope it helped that you have a first glimpse on, okay, that we take over the use case into Cloud ALM, but we do it in a little different adapted form. And that is because we learned in the last 50 to 20 years of ALM deployment, but also we see that we have just a different landscape gravity at our customers. And therefore the ALM that did the job 15 or 20 years ago is not the ALM that we would need for the hybrid and perhaps even cloud-only landscapes that we are seeing today and going forward at our customers. Yeah, and with that, I would like to come to a pause and allow you to ask a couple of questions.
Thank you, Mark. There are already some in the chat and some in the Q&A pod. So the custom code question you answered already in a few seconds ago. So then we have a question in SAP Cloud ALM is there ICMON?
Internet connection monitor. Let's say that technical capability on that very technical level is not yet there. I don't know exactly what Janko is planning here. I would have to defer you here on the presentations of Janko. Overall, whenever it is really something that is deeply on-prem and non-ABAP centric, yeah. We are not planning that, but I think ICMON is a capability that is also ABAP relevant. And from that perspective, at least that part, yeah, the ABAP part, I expect to be also available going forward in Cloud ALM.
Thank you. And then will there be also S4 on-premise monitors?
S4 on-premise monitors are already available today. We have actually BPMon for S4 on-prem. We have integration monitoring for S4 on-prem. We have real user monitoring for S4 on-prem. And we have just launched health monitoring for S4 on-prem. So already available today.
Thank you very much. And then we have actually a last question in the chat that is open, and it's more a general question. If I understood correctly, all these 16 areas will still be improved till 2027.
On Solution Manager?
I mean for the on-prem.
Well, I mean, what means improved? I mean, in Cloud ALM, we are actually obviously working on those 16 areas, right? And I've tried to explain you what we have today, right? And what still in 2022 mainly will come. Yeah. So Cloud ALM obviously has this high speed of updates, yeah, where we deploy daily. So every day, Cloud ALM looks a little bit different. And then every 2 weeks, we release then the features, decouple it from the toggles, and then you see it, yeah? So there's this very fast pace of additional content support and functional improvements, yeah? On the Solution Manager side, we also said that we are also improving Solution Manager, but here we are basically working via customer connection, and we have a focus on improvement in the areas of process documentation, charm and test management.
Okay. And then we got another one in the Q&A pod actually coming in. What's about SLD and LMDB?
SLD and MLD. Okay, so the landscape management of Solution Manager, I mean, there is obviously an counterpart in Cloud ALM where we basically have also a landscape management as an underlying framework in Cloud ALM. That is tightly connected to the cloud landscapes that we know in our in-house cloud operations. So basically, when you are logging onto Cloud ALM, we have already the knowledge of the, let's say, cloud systems that SAP operates for you. However, you would still need to connect the cloud, the cloud system, yeah, into Cloud ALM, because we don't know basically the user management, the credentials. We have actually currently even a trial in our labs prepared, where we are trying to do, let's say, an SAP managed connectivity setup, right? Where you don't need to do the connectivity anymore, but I cannot promise you if that setup improvements will really materialize, because it's not a simple job to do. Yeah. But I mean, yes, we have a landscape management in Cloud ALM, yeah, and that tightly integrates into the landscape knowledge, the cloud landscape management of our cloud operations, yeah. But it also allows you to connect like in Solution Manager, your on-prem landscape and even third-party landscape into Cloud ALM.
Thank you, Mark. So we have still some questions coming in, but we also have the time passed by. So let's take this into the Meet the Expert round. I've noted them down and can hand it over to you in the Meet the Expert, Mark, if that is fine for you.
Or absolutely, do you want fine to... with me. Thanks to the audience for the interest, for listening in. Enjoy the event continuously, and looking forward to see you on the expert sessions in the evening.